वंस अगेन गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. टुडे वील बी लर्निंग अबाउट द बेंडिंग ऑफ कर्व्ड बीम्स. दैट मीन्स अनसिमेट्रिकल बेंडिंग ऑफ कर्व्ड बीम्स. अप टू नाउ वी वर लर्निंग अबाउट द सेक्शंस विच वर इनिशियली स्ट्रेट और दे आर नॉट कर्व्ड बट they might be having a rectangular section or an I section, whatever it may be, but they are straight beams. But now we are now going to analyze the bending of initially curved beams. Okay, and this section is called as Winkler-Batch formula. So in the last section we were discussing on straight beams. Here we are dealing with unsymmetrical bending of curved beams. Okay, since this variation of stress in this type of beams are not linear in case of straight beams, as in case of depending on the straight beams, the stresses are linear throughout, right? Here they are linear, stresses are linear, but because it depends on x. Okay, but here it's not like that. Also, experimentally it is proved that stresses in concave side of a beam, that means if this is an initially bent surface, this concave, if you are applying load, or even before applying load, there will be stresses will be more in this section on the concave side, and it will be always greater, because since this is a bent section, here you will be having compression and here tension, right? Clear? So stresses in this section will be higher than this section. So initially the system is having like this. So it is concluded that, so for straight beams what happens, you have a neutral axis here, right? When it has undergone bending, this will have compression up to neutral axis, then tension. But here initially itself it is bent. Okay, initially itself compressive stress and tensile stress acts here. Now after applying load, what happens? Again the system, the properties have changed. So it has been concluded that the neutral axis in this case will not pass through the centroid. As in the case of a rectangular section, here the neutral axis will not be passing through the centroid of this beam. So if this GG is the centroidal axis, the neutral axis might be a distance away from the centroidal axis. Okay, clear? Now we'll analyze and we'll show you the definitions. If O is the center from which the object is bent initially, okay, so the distance RO is the distance from the center to the neutral axis, and rho naught is the distance from center to the centroidal axis. Since this is bent initially, you will be having moment in both sides. The distance, okay, this distance, that means you have this distance between neutral axis NA and GG, centroidal axis, is called as E. Okay, that means in last session we named it as eccentricity, but here we'll just give the name as E. Okay, now the given terms have M is applied moment, A is area of cross section, GG is centroidal axis, NA is neutral axis, is distance between neutral axis and central axis. Y means if you need to find out the distance at this point, so y is the distance from that point where you need to find out the stress and neutral axis. Okay. Clear? distance from neutral axis to point where stress is to be found. Rho naught and R0 I have already explained. Okay, so for these types of problems, the bending stress will be this equation. You just need to mug up this equation. You need to know, no need of derivations here. Okay, and see, for this particular problem, since the neutral axis is above this centroidal axis, the stress that we need to find out is undergoing compression. Up to here, this is compressing, and from there it is tensile. Okay, so this is the point where we need to find the stress. So that point is undergoing compression. So for that purpose, this is minus here, MYAER0 minus Y. Okay, so for different cases, this can be a circular section, a rectangular section, trapezoidal section, many sections can be there. Okay, but in our syllabus, we just need to find out the rectangular section. Okay, for if you cut a section from here, that will be a rectangle. Okay, that case only we need to refer. Okay, for that we'll include one or two terms. Okay, if this is the rectangle, see, if this is the cut section which is rectangular in cross section, the same concepts applied, but you have few more terms. Rectangular section is having height h and breadth b, and r1 is the distance from this coordinate axis to the upper fiber of the rectangle. Okay, and r2 is to the bottom fiber. Okay, r0 and r0 are similar to this condition, from the coordinate axis to neutral axis and centroidal axis distance. Distance between neutral axis and central axis is E. Okay. Okay. Now, for rectangular sections, this the same equation, but we have another two terms here. Okay. So, the equation becomes, you need to find out the relation between R1 and R2, right? So, R0 is equal to H by natural logarithm of R2 by R1, and E is equal to R0 minus R, so rho naught minus R0, because H is, that you can find out from here itself. E, the distance of E is rho naught minus R0. So here R0 is a value, this value you need to find out. You need to mug up H by natural logarithm of R2 by, okay, sorry for that. And so, E, you can find it from this thing itself. Okay. So, the equation is the same. From here, the value of R0 will be this one for rectangular section. That's the only difference. Okay. So, this equation is called as Winkler-Bash formula. We'll do one problem and we'll wind up this session. And this module also. Okay, so you need to find out the maximum tensile stress at the section AA. For this section, what will be the maximum tensile stress? You need to find out. So this section has been given like this. This is a rectangular section of height 6 cm and this is 4 cm. R1, R2 is this values. You need to find out that. How will you find out? R1 is, from here, this radius is 8 cm. R1 is 8. R2 is 8 plus this distance, 6. Okay, similarly, you need to find out all these values. This will be the centroidal axis and neutral axis. You need to find out. Okay, see. F is given as 2000 Newton. Here, they have given 2000 Newton. A is given, that means area of that rectangular section. Okay, sigma x is this one. Moment is force into distance, so 200 into 200 sorry 2000 into up to the centroidal distance. Okay, 8 plus 8 plus this distance is 3. Okay, 8 plus 8 plus 3. Okay, you'll convert it to mm. Okay, rho naught is, what is rho naught? From here to the centroid, right? From this coordinate axis to this centroid, 8 plus 3. Okay, we'll get 110 mm. R naught is h by natural log of R2 by R1, 60 by long, natural log of 140 by 80. Similarly, you will get, substitute in this equation, you will get E. And maximum tensile stress will be at B, because this tensile stress will be maximum at the outer section, right? So from that point, Y will be minus of E plus 30. Why this minus? From the centroidal axis, this is moving downwards. So this equation is minus of E plus 30. What is E? This distance is E. So Y means from here is the stress that we need to find out to the neutral axis. Neutral axis point we don't know. Okay. So that distance will be 30 plus, sorry, the whole distance minus 30, right? Minus E, minus of E plus 30. Okay, so Y is, you found out, substitute in this equation. Okay, you have found out the sigma X, and this is the bending stress. Okay, you need to find out the total stress. For that, when it undergone direct loading, minus F by A, you'll get a small value, minus 0.833 Newton per m square. So net tensile stress will be 13.33 minus 0.833. That means you got the total tensile stress on the section B. Okay, I hope you understood that. The only difference for the only thing is that you need to mug up this Winkler-Bash formula. See this formula, and for rectangular section you should be aware that R naught value is this one, and then you do the problem. For the questions can be asked in any manner, but the same pattern can be repeated. Okay, thank you for listening. Thank you.